The Nebraska State Legislature passed a bill in 1919 providing for construction of a new Capitol building. Heading the project was New York architect Bertram Goodhue. Assisting were Hartley B. Alexander, the department head of philosophy at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, as consultant for inscription and symbolism, Lee Lowry, a renowned sculptor, and Hildreth Meyer, a designer of mosaic tiles. Meyer was born in New York City in 1892 and became inspired by Renaissance architecture after living in Florence, Italy during her adolescence. Upon returning to the United States, she met Goodhue and not long after began work on the decorative mosaic tiles in the Nebraska State Capitol building. The mosaic tile floor of the Rotunda was being created throughout 1928. Meyer and Alexander strived to create an aesthetically pleasing mosaic piece in the Rotunda, and they were concerned with the scientific integrity of the fossil record, which comprised the majority of the Rotunda floor. Director of the University of Nebraska State Museum, Irwin Hinckley Barber, was called on to help create scientific sketches of extinct species. The Nebraska State Museum had built a reputation for itself as having one of the foremost collections of fossils in the world. Barber was a prolific and experienced field geologist and paleontologist, and was a talented artist. He had also discovered many species, including the mammoth and saber-toothed cat. The marble mosaic tile floor is in the classical architectural design of a guilloche, an ornamental pattern or border consisting of paired ribbons or lines flowing in interlaced curves around a series of circular voids. Several issues arose with the fossil drawings, including some species which would not fit well in the galoche, such as the duck-billed dinosaur and ammonite, which had to be modified. The process of creating the mosaic floor was meticulous. Meyer developed full-sized ink drawings based on Barber's original sketches, which she glued face down directly onto the tiles for each segment of the galoche. The ink drawings were later removed, destroying the originals, but leaving the mosaic figure on the floor. The Rotunda floor comprises five allegorical circles connected by interlacing ribbons of the Nebraska fossil record. In the center of the galoche is a large sun surrounding an image of a powerful woman representing the earth as a life giver. A person on either side, one holding wheat and the other water, represent industry and commerce. A young boy sprawled out at the woman's feet, along with the basket of overflowing fruit, signify Nebraska's vast opportunity and resources. The four elemental circles about Mother Nature symbolize Nebraska's potential and wealth. The first circle is water, representing the abundance of water from rivers and the Ogallala Aquifer. The second is fire, signifying the passion and spirit of Nebraska's people and heritage. The third circle is air, symbolizing enriching wind and soaring aspirations. The fourth and final circle is earth or soil, which represent Nebraska's agricultural production and work ethic, a driving force of business in the state and integral to the prosperity of human societies across time and borders. The ribbon connecting these circles reveals the prehistoric life in Nebraska. The ribbon serves as a timeline or fossil record and enhances the allegory of the four elements. Around each elemental circle is a ribbon with prehistoric life corresponding to that element. The water circle has such prehistoric plants and animals as a sea urchin and mollusk, which thrived in the ocean many hundred million years ago. The fire circle has mainly dinosaurs surrounding it, dating back to several million years ago, representing the warm climate of that period. The air circle represents the evolution of dinosaur into bird, 65 million years ago, when an extinction event forced species to evolve, many taking to the air or sea. The circle of soil is surrounded by plants and land animals living respectively over 1 million years ago, including the mammoth. Archie, the state Nebraska fossil residing in Morrill Hall, makes a cameo in this section of the galoche. Government philosophy and science integrate and form the theme of elemental balance in the Rotunda, implying balance in government, environment, and society. The galoche also refers to a biological prehistory of Nebraska, as well as a symbolic balance explained by the four elements. The fossil record and elemental patterns reflect the ceiling in the Rotunda, based on the eight virtues of the state, revealing how science and spirit interact to form the basis of human inspiration and mindset. The Rotunda is not only the center of the state capitol building, but also the heart of Nebraska. The ornate mosaic floor illustrates Nebraska values, represents a biological prehistory, and suggests the enriching notion of what Nebraska has to offer, not only the United States of America in terms of government, but the world in terms of human ingenuity and spirit.